The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Saint Luke.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Jesus said to the Pharisees, "There was a rich man who dressed in purple garments and fine linen, and dined sumptuously each day. And lying at his door was a poor man named Lazarus, covered with sores, who would gladly have eaten his fill of the scraps that fell from the rich man's table. Dogs even used to come and lick his sores. When the poor man died, he was carried away by angels to the bosom of Abraham. The rich man also died and was buried, and from the netherworld, where he was in torment, he raised his eyes and saw Abraham far off and Lazarus at his side. And he cried out, 'Father Abraham, have pity on me. Send Lazarus to dip the tip of his finger in water and cool my tongue, for I am suffering torment in these flames.' Abraham replied, 'My child, remember that you receive what was good during your lifetime, while Lazarus likewise received what was bad. But now he is comforted here, whereas you are tormented. Moreover, between us and you, a great chasm is established to prevent anyone from crossing who might wish to go from our side to yours and from yours to ours.' He said, 'Then I beg you, Father, send him to my father's house, for I have five brothers, so that he may warn them, lest they too come to this place of torment.' But Abraham replied, 'They have Moses and the prophets. Let them listen to them.' He said, 'Oh no, Father Abraham, but if someone from the dead goes to them, they will repent.' Then Abraham said, 'If they will not listen to Moses and the prophets, neither will they be persuaded if someone should rise from the dead.'" My friends, the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Good morning, my dear brothers and sisters. One misconception that could be thought of with the story of the rich man and Lazarus in our gospel is that rich people will go to hell and poor people in heaven. That's a misconception, because this was the ending of the story of the rich man and Lazarus. A misconception. That is why we could ask, is it bad to be rich? Is it bad to be rich? Of course, we know the answer. Not. It's not bad. Our social status has nothing to do with salvation, not even our lifestyle, but our way of life does. Our way of life does. Ang ating katayuan sa lipunan ay walang kinalaman sa kaligtasan, maging ang ating pamumuhay, kundi ang ating paraan ng pamumuhay. Our way of life. This is what happened to the rich man. Despite being blessed, the rich man does not care and is indifferent or unbothered by those who are in need. Walang pakialam yung mayamang lalaki. As described, Lazarus would gladly have eaten his fill of the scraps that fell from the rich man's table. Imagine food falling from the table. Para may mahulog sa hapag, ibig sabihin puno ang mesa. Isn't it? Para may mahulog na mumo, ibig sabihin sobra-sobra. Imagine, di ba? While you are eating, kapag punong-puno yung kutsara, if your spoon is full, the tendency is food will fall. That's how blessed the rich man was. Punong-puno, sagana, marami. At sa sobrang dami, nasasayang, natatapon, nahuhulog. I remember, nung bata pa kami, kailangan naming simutin lahat ng pagkain na nasa plato namin. Ang turo sa amin, bawat butil dapat kakainin. Walang ititira. Dahil ang turo, huwag magsasayang ng pagkain. Everything on our plate should be eaten. Nothing should be wasted. Even a grain of rice, we have to eat. We have to clean our plate. Nothing will be wasted. Huwag magsasayang. Kasi ang turo sa amin, huwag magsayang ng pagkain sapagkat marami ang nagugutom. We should not waste our food because many are hungry. Pero yung mga pilosopong sagot ng iba sa panahon ngayon, kapag bakinain ko lahat ng yan, mabubusog ang mga nagugutom. Di ba? Narinig niyo yung ganon? Di ba? Pilosopo, no? Even if I eat all of these, are the hungry would have their fill? Kaya yung pilosopo, yung nakakatawa eh, no? Pero maaring hindi mabusog ang mga nagugutom, pero ang pakikiramay sa kanilang kalagayan na hindi tayo nag-aaksaya ay isang paraan na may pakialam tayo, na may kamalayan tayo. Eating our food is our sympathy and empathy to those who have none. That's why we should not waste. Huwag mong sasayangin because that is our empathy to those who have nothing. What we could do is to reach out to those who have none. Kung di mo pala kayang ubusin, sa susunod, ipamimigay mo yung sobra mo. Kung di mo pala kaya lahat, sa susunod, reach out to those who have none. This is where the rich man failed. That it has become his way of life. He failed in reaching out to Lazarus, to poor man. That it has become his way of life. Sa araw-araw na lumipas, na kumakain siya ng masarap at marami, hindi man lang niya pinansin ang walang-wala na nasa labas ng kanyang pinto. Every day of her life, he eats so much without noticing the needs of those who have none, without empathy. This is also what the Lord said in the preaching of the prophet Jeremiah in our first reading. The Lord alone probed the mind and test the heart to reward everyone according to his ways, according to the merits of his deeds. Sa Tagalog, ang sabi ng Panginoon, akong Panginoon ang sumisiyasat sa isip at sumusubok sa puso ng tao. Ginagantihan ko ang bawat isa ayon sa kanyang pamumuhay at ginagantimpalaan ayon sa kanyang ginagawa. My dear brothers and sisters, this Lent, we examine our hearts and check how much love do we have, or has it been filled with indifference over the years? We all have hearts, but does it fill with love, or have we filled it with indifference? Remember, it is through our way of life that we will be rewarded. In the end, not our lifestyle, but our way of life will be our great reward. Amen.